Cari rocker di ST Television, ben trovati dallo splendido museo del rock di Catanzaro per questo imperdibile Prog Evening, evento organizzato dallo stesso museo guidato dall'ideatore e direttore artistico Pier Giorgio Caruso. Una serata di grande musica all'insegna del prog, con due importanti realtà calabresi legate in qualche modo a questa tradizione, i catanzaresi Le Hibou e il cantautore di Sersale Carmine Torchia. Ma chi è un'assoluta istituzione del prog è lo special guest di questa serata, il grande Richard Sinclair, autentica icona della scena di Canterbury, leader di band fondamentali come Caravan e Hetfield and the North, protagonista tra l'altro nella seconda metà degli anni 70 anche nei Camel. Sinclair ha la seconda apparizione in Calabria in meno di un anno, dopo il concerto di Lamezia Terme per il Suoni del Sud Festival di Marcello Nicotra e Tommaso Colloca, che è riuscito a riportare dalle nostre parti questa autentica leggenda della scena di Canterbury. Welcome to the land of grey and pink.
Grazie.
Grazie.
Allora, siamo a Canterbury 1965, un gruppo di ragazzi in piena Beatlemania decidono di mettersi a suonare. Tutti ragazzini di talento, alcuni Robert Wyatt, Hugh Cooper, Mike Rutledge formeranno i Soft Machine che sono esposti lì. Un esule australiano, un ragazzino che si chiamava David Allen formerà i Gong. A un certo punto si presentò questo giovanottino che all'epoca aveva 15-16 anni, dimostrò talento, entrò nella band, una specie di collettivo musicale che si chiamava Wildflowers, e andarono avanti per qualche anno. Poi si separarono, ognuno prese la sua strada, lui formò i Caravan. I Caravan sono una band importantissima del rock progressivo dell'epoca, ma hanno fatto 3 o 4 LP molto belli e altri dopo la sua uscita. Ma sappiate che tutte le canzoni più belle e più importanti dei Caravan le ha scritte Richard Sinclair. Quindi continuerà l'avventura in un'altra band un attimino più sperimentale, meno romantica, meno melodica, si chiama Hatfield and the North, altri due capolavori, poi entrerà nei Camel, quindi di volta in volta suonerà con altre band che non vi sto qui a elencare, fin quando non decide questo giovanotto di venire in Puglia ad abitare, perché evidentemente la musica deve essere inglese, però il clima forse in Italia ce l'abbiamo meglio. Signore e signori, Richard Sinclair.
Ovviamente lui è la star, ma ad accompagnarlo c'è il professor Gianluca Milanese, che è considerato da Jazz It uno dei 10 migliori flauti traversi che abbiamo in Italia.
This is called disassociation. You know, there's a place where I can go, where I listen to the cars. So this is it.
And it brings it all back to me.
or will it snow? There's not much chance of that. There are people waiting here who really want to know. Can't you feel it in the air? I wonder what it's meant to be. It's the thoughts that can despair. Sometimes I think of wine, songs and laughter flowing free, people talking all the time, and it brings it all back to me. Yes, it brings it all back to me. Brings it all back.
Mr. Sinclair, welcome back in Calabria, and thank you for your willingness. You are one of the most representative artists of a very singular and important movement in prog history and in rock history too, Canterbury scene. It was a peculiar fantasy sound, a little bit different from classic English progressive. An almost surrealistic fusion of psychedelic and jazz elements, avant-garde, and sometimes Dada culture.
A mixture. Canterbury. It's funny, isn't it? I get asked a lot of questions about Canterbury because really they were all songwriters, okay? Yeah. You can name all the people that get related to Canterbury because it comes from one. It's by the press, okay, to do with the media music, and in 1963, I was asked by the Hopper brothers, Brian and Hugh Hopper, to go and make a band with them because they wanted to make a band in Canterbury. And Hugh's parents lived in Canterbury, and Hugh's parents used to come and see my father play music. He was a musician in Canterbury, okay, and round the area in Canterbury. He was a singer, he was a bass player, a drummer, and an entertainer of many of all the pop music from 1930s to 1980s when he died. And so I got introduced to what became, as you know, the Canterbury scene, you know. Really, my Canterbury scene is my family. It's my grandfather in the turn of the century
in Canterbury was an entertainer of music, which was very difficult then because Canterbury is the head of the Church of England. And so my musical inheritance and inheritance comes from my family, okay? So the Canterbury scene, as you know it, is what's been told from what came from Wildflowers was Soft Machine first, and then Caravan. Okay, and that's the sort of history of the thing. And then all those musicians cross-referenced to many, many other musicians. They were all songwriters, as in with the Soft Machine. You had Robert Wyatt's voice. David Allen was in it, first of all, with Gong. His voice, songwriter. Kevin Ayers. Hugh Hopper, a songwriter. Many, many songwriters. You know, Pye Hastings, songwriter. David Sinclair, songwriter. Nice. I was lucky to play with them all, okay. So, but the Canterbury scene, you know, there's some funny stories and why it is and why it all gets particularly related to one group, one gender of musicians. The Canterbury scene is the press, okay? Yeah. And you're grouped together because of a familiar sound which was very fashionable at the 60s into the 70s. And then this sound carries on, you know. For me, Canterbury was family. Family and friends, okay? We were mates, you know. All mates and friends together. Some of it psychedelic, some of it, you know, vaudeville, some of it rock, some of it jazz, some of it da-da-da-da, whatever it is, you know, good mixture.
So, everything started with Wildflowers. From Wildflowers, we arrived to two different phases of Canterbury sound, Soft Machine and Caravan.
Can we talk about pop side of that scene for Caravan?
It was all popular music, pop music for me. You know, it's like, it depends who what you term it. I mean, it was quite psychedelic, the Soft Machine in the beginning, like Pink Floyd. I mean, so was Soft Machine, it was popular music, okay? No, we were just trying to make some music and make popular music. Especially if you sell an album like Landogram Pink, not the biggest selling album, it's on sale every day. For me, the Wildflowers, I'm not so interested in blues music. I enjoy it because other people enjoy it. But, you know, it's like I listen to jazz a lot now. And when I was 15 years old, in 1963, there was an album called Out to Lunch. And it was some music that I'd never even wanted to listen to. And I listened to it for 2 years. It's Eric Dolphy. Eric Dolphy, the jazz clarinet player. It was fantastic. It sounded like he was playing in the nature, you know. And so I was intrigued by it. I thought, what is this, you know? What is this timing? Why is it going? You know, it's fantastic. But I was still orientated to write simple tunes, but with more chordal approach than the blues thing. You know, if you listen to the first tunes that I composed on the first Caravan album, there's a few chords, more than three, you know, it's like...
In the land of grey and pink, where only Boy Scouts. Coming back again. Lofty, grumbly grin is up there, climbing down your chimney, trying to get in. Come to take your money. Is that a sin? They're so thin. There's black pockets in the sky. Only your dad in Lorraine. Cigarettes burn bright tonight. They all get washed down the drain. So we say. land where the buckwheat grows. Won't need any money, just fingers and your toes. When it's dark, a boat will park on the land of warm and green. Pick our fill of buckwheat. We'll need. There's black buckets in the sky. Don't leave your dad in the rain. Cigarettes burn bright tonight, they all get washed down the drain. Just one day to the land where the buckwheat grows. Won't need any money, just fingers and your toes. When it's dark, a boat will park on the land of warm and green. Pick up your buckwheat, talk it to me, that's all we'll need. Cigarettes burn bright tonight, let all get warm in the land. To healer. Tell me everything. Don't be winter wine. It's gonna be June. Later, I do that later. Yeah. Winter wine. Are you always solo singing all your tunes? Okay. Oh. diary written in braille. Oh, I don't want this to be one more new nostalgic tale, like Chaucer's Tales of Canterbury written in braille. I've had enough of that, and I'm bored with cups of tea and riffs in 58, Ella Hatfield and the North. Clever rhythmic signatures, tricky dicky chords, rehearsing for a week, the bloody middle eight. Thank you. not trying to be soft, stuck in England, not in Jupiter or Mars. Oh well, there you go for now.
In 77, in Full Punk Explosion, you joined another important prog band, Camel. Which memories do you have of that period, especially of Rain Dance's sessions?
What nice music. Peter Barnes, very, very nice writer. I came as a session musician with Camel because I could play bass and sing. And that's why I was asked to do that, and it was lovely singing, you know, boom, ba boom, ba da do do, ba dum, boom, ba do do. Camel is now Andy Latimer's band. It's Andy Latimer's band, you know. It used to be Pete Bardens and Andy Latimer, and I very much enjoyed that combination. That was the best combination for me. Very nice, and it was one of the most professional touring bands that I'd been in, because it was very nice, very good.
Now you're living in Italy for 10 years. Yeah, how was this passion for our country born?
A weather. So I live in a stone truly house that collects water. It's lovely in the summer, it's cold in the winter. It's like living in Kent, southern England, on the southeast, like Puglia, southeast of Italy. I have a lot of friends that like the music of Caravan, Hatfield in the North, particularly in Puglia, yeah. Particularly in Puglia, they like Hatfield in the North, and they're musicians, so they know all the, you know, Rotters Club and Hatfield music, and they know Caravan music, and not so many know Camel music down here, and they particularly like Rain Dances and Breathless and a live record, you know. They know about Snow Goose, which was their most important. Yeah, I had good fun in Camel, I really thought. Thank you.
can buy one, fall right to the brim. So of course I had to have one, I call it three.
Dalla Prog Evening con Lei Bu, Carmine Torchi e Sua Maestà Richard Sinclair dal Museo del Rock di Catanzaro è tutto. Alla prossima, rock and roll!